But we do want to check back in with Alicia as your donations continue to come in for our 7 Gives Feeding Families Day. Mm-hmm. It is a day-long effort to support Forgotten Harvest, and there are trucks that are already there. Alicia, you were saying earlier that things were getting underway. What kind of activity is going on at the Forgotten Harvest Warehouse now?
Well, you know what? Pallets of food, like this whole cardboard box full of fresh bread, boxes of tomatoes, grapes, kale, you name it. They've already been loaded up on trucks at these docking bays. You can hear the engine from one truck that's waiting to head out. And it's because this operation does this all week long, year round, and the man who knows all about it, the man who helps run it, is the CEO of Forgotten Harvest, Adrian Lewis. Thank you so much for being with us. You're relatively new to this job. You've had it 5 months.
5 months.
But you've been in the food industry for years.
For many years, over 30 years.
There you go. This is a passion for you. It's a cause close to your heart. What makes Forgotten Harvest so unique?
Well, Alicia, definitely there are other food rescue organizations, but what our uniqueness is that we're able to not only rescue the food, but bring it back to our warehouse, distribute it equitably by food group to ensure that all of our neighbors in need are getting a nutritious meal. And to be able to do that on an annual basis is unique within itself.
How many people do you reach a year?
Over 750,000. Households per year. So
in Wayne, Oakland, and Macomb County.
Wayne, Oakland, Macomb counties. Definitely that can look, if you look at, you know, 1 in 6 children that are hungry and in need, and not to mention our senior population, to be able to contribute to that is just an amazing thought. It's an amazing mission. And for us and our staff, we do that from our hearts. And we really appreciate all the help from our donors. And donors can definitely give by food, but of course the monetary donations are very, very
because
helpful.
Running an operation like this, walk us through, it's a 77,000 square foot warehouse. Walk us through what it takes to keep this thing humming.
Well, it takes dedicated staff members for sure, but to be able to, again, our drivers who are just daily out there as ambassadors are out there picking up the nutritious foods, bringing it back. And also our wonderful warehouse staff. As you can see how neatly organized from an operational excellence, food safety included, we're doing this at the utmost of excellence. And also we're able to do it, again, free of charge.
And you
to
have
the end user.
Free of charge. That is the big thing right there.
Yes.
And just how spotless this entire warehouse is. I feel like I could eat off the floor. More than 7,000 volunteers come here to help sort through the food every day. Adrian, we salute you and the entire team at Forgotten Harvest. And we're going to try and raise money to keep your operation buzzing.
Thank you.
It's easy for you at home to help out. We encourage you to donate today to 7 Gives Feeding Families. It's really easy to do so. Just go to WXYZ.com. You can donate online there, or you can text WXYZ to 50155, or you can scan the QR code that you see right there on the screen. But Adrian, again, thanks to you and your entire staff and all of the volunteers for what you do year-round to help so many families in need.
Thank you, Alicia, and thank you all of WXYZ's listeners and viewers.
You know what? $5,000 is going to be matched by Channel 7 and the Scripps Howard Fund today.
Yes.
So get those donations in.
Let's
Keenan,
do it.
People have incentive.
Oh, with that.
Keenan.
Hey, how's it going, Adrian?
Hey, how's it going?
A great incentive indeed. And, you know, it's the great work of folks like Adrian that really changed lives here, and we can all help out. Thank you so much, Alicia. We'll check back in with you in just a bit.